like the video. Let's hear it for Secretary Howe. Isn't she awesome? What she said. That, now I can sit down. But seriously, I want to thank Yvonne Howe for her energy, which is boundless, as you can see, and for really embracing this opportunity to be a champion for our great state. And that's the business that you're in every single day. And it's important for you to know and hear directly from our fabulous Secretary of Economic Development that that's how she sees her role as well. And key to our growth and economic development in this state is the recognition that the travel and the tourism space is so vital. It's integral to the fabric of communities and neighborhoods, who we are as a commonwealth, and we know, you know, that it is a huge economic engine if we tap into it. So I am really grateful to Secretary Howe, grateful to Kate Fox also for coming on board and accepting this responsibility to lead us, grateful to Sheila Green, grateful to everybody, whether you're working on Mass 250 or you're working within Mott. I wanna thank everybody on our internal team for the work they've done in putting this terrific conference together. I also want to acknowledge Chair Paul Mark and Chair Mindy Dom, as well as so many legislative colleagues. I see Representative Michelle Ciccolo here. I see Representative Machino. I'm sure there are many others across the room who I am missing. But it's just to say I appreciate, we really value the partnership that we have with our legislature, and especially legislative partners who understand and share the view that this is where it's at. This is where it's at, and we want to drive our tourism economy. We want to drive our creative economy. And Michael Bobbitt from Mass Cultural Council, great to see you. We appreciate the many ways in which so many people have really leaned into it this year. I also was a little surprised to know that it had been 10 years. I don't know what happened, but we were clear. And Yvonne was right. When we heard, you know, we were like, no, we're gonna do it now. Because we wanted to establish the tone and the tenor for our administration out of the gate. And that's a tone and a tenor that values this stuff, really, really values this stuff. And so we appreciate everybody who came together to make this happen. Many thanks to our servers here today, to all the folks, management as well, at the Hilton, who have done a fantastic job of hosting us, along with our great partners at Massport, who support us all in so many ways, here in Boston, over at the Port, Worcester, throughout the state. We appreciate everything that you do. Every day you work to literally bring the world to Massachusetts. So we're bringing back this conference, and we want to recognize as well, and I just want to lift up for a moment the opportunities before us. You know, we've been through a lot. We've been through a lot with the pandemic. We're living in challenging times in our nation, as we know. But I really believe that, you know, in the face of that and in the face of an increasingly competitive world, one of the tenets of our administration is that we are fighting to make Massachusetts more competitive in every realm, and we're competing against other states. Secretary Howe mentioned Virginia and Pennsylvania wanting to own the revolution. We're not going to let that happen. But more than that, we're going to make sure that we're putting our best foot forward when it comes to competition. Competition against other regions, against other states, and really against other destination places worldwide. And that's why when we put together an economic development plan, we talk about reaffirming Massachusetts as the global hub of life sciences, setting a high mark to make sure that Massachusetts becomes the global hub for climate tech, the next innovation that we need to seize. And with that, making sure that we also do things like lean into this great tourism economy as an economic engine. Now, we know that we have some impressive numbers to show, thanks to the work of so many people in this room who found new ways to innovate. I personally think disruption's good. One of the things I've encouraged in our administration across agencies and secretariats is don't be afraid to do things differently. because the status quo has only gotten us so far. If we need a state that's going to be more affordable, more equitable, and more competitive, we cannot let us maintain the status quo. We have to be empowered to do things differently. Sometimes we're forced to do things differently. And I think this is where everybody in this room had to turn on a dime a few years ago. But look at some of what came out of that in terms of new capabilities and new potential and new understandings. In 2022, still under the shadow of the pandemic, the Massachusetts tourism industry generated almost $25 billion in visitor spending. It supported over 130,000 jobs statewide, and it produced, we like this right now, this time of year, $2 billion in tax revenue for our state. So thank you. It's also more, so much more than the numbers. It's our identity. It's how we tell our story, both our history and also what we want our future to be. It's how we create a feeling here across the state and around the world that Massachusetts is a place that you have to see and a place that you want to be. As we move forward, that reputation is critical to our success. Now, we know we're known for our history. It's right, the tea in the harbor, the shot heard around the world. Every day I have the privilege of walking into our state house where the corner foundation stone was laid by Sam Adams and Paul Revere, right? Amazing stuff. We walk outside and there's a wonderful depiction of the 54th Regiment depicted most recently in the movie Denzel Washington, not so recent, Glory. But where the 54th mustered, right? Set off, you know, ordered by a governor to go and fight the war to end slavery. There's so much we could talk about in our great state, and that's just a couple miles from here. Say nothing of the Berkshires, Paul, and we love the Berkshires, north, south, everywhere. The history across this Commonwealth is incredible. I was in Worcester the other day. I didn't know that Worcester invented rocket and the birth control pill. Worcester, heart of the Commonwealth. I mean, so innovation. Innovation has been in our DNA, whether it was figuring out how to cure diseases and save lives, or pioneering the first school in the country, the first library in the country, also the first mutual fund in the country. You told me that. Who knew? So, you know, and so much more. I could talk about the first newspaper, the first lighthouse, the first railroad, yes, subway. That's why we got some work to do. The first computer, the internet, right down the road, 1962. I'm going to sound like Al Gore, but I mean it. 1962, MIT. First in women's rights, universal health care, marriage equality, and yes, the first volleyball game and that other winter sport, basketball, right here in Massachusetts. So we're a hub of innovation, of independence, of inclusion, and of progress. That's the story that we share. And that's part of the vision, right, for Massachusetts 250. Or you're going to tell me, is it MA 250? MA 250. We're going to work on this. I love this and all the iterations. I know that the LG shared the logo this morning. I'm sorry I missed the reenactors and muskets. I don't know what was going on. Drums. It's great. Isn't she great? Isn't the LG great? Nobody believes. You think about what she did in Salem, right? Everybody wants to go to Salem. I have people come in and visit. You know, they're like ambassadors and different people want to come in and visit these delegations from other places. It's like, okay, they're here to see Boston. And then they're like, well, we want to go see Salem. I'm like, what? Okay. She with Kate Fox, they put Salem on the map. And, you know, I just say that because that's how much she believes in this space. And so much more. The BSO, Tanglewood, Jacob's Pillow, Shakespeare Company, theaters. I was up recently at the new Groton Hill Music Center. Unbelievable. Shailen Liu up in, you know, where I'm from, in the Cape Ann. I mean, so many places. Outdoor recreation. Stand up with your outdoor recreation vest. 11 ski hills. 450,000 acres of state parks overseen by DCR. Properties managed by the trustees, Mass Audubon, Historic New England, and New England Forestry. Iconic museums, attractions, and events from Mass MoCA to the MFA, the Boston Marathon, and the Hall of Fame. and we're always looking to do more. We're going to be playing soccer in a couple years. Seven World Cup matches are going to be hosted here. We're going to have another visit from the tall ships. I remember that as a kid, 1976. Amazing, in the heart of America's 250 celebrations. This past year, I don't know how many were down for the Army-Navy game. One of three times it was held outside of the Philadelphia region, and I think there was a poll done. I mean, this is sold out, we know, including fans from all 50 states here in Massachusetts for that game. Do you know that over three quarters of the people who attended that game and were surveyed said that their experience in Massachusetts was as good or better than other years, typically held in Philadelphia, by the way. So, and thank you to Martha Sheridan and a whole bunch of folks who worked on that. So look, we've got incredible opportunities for growth. We do hope you get on board and help support the Mass Leads Act, because we think this is really important for getting us to where we need to be. And there's more I'm going to say, but you know, I think I've said enough. You know, I love this state deeply, deeply. Some of you, my grandparents came here in the 40s, Irish immigrants. My grandmother and grandfather, and then early in the 20th century, my great grandmother came here from Ballinasloe and Galway, to Massachusetts, all of them. But before that, 1636, on my mom's side, landed in the Parker River up in Essex County in Newbury. Yeah, so I love Massachusetts, so. I'm very proud to be able to serve as your governor. I'm so proud of the team that I get to work with every single day. Thank you all for what you do. And thank you all out there for what you do day in and day out. In a time of challenge, in a time of negativity out there, in a time of pessimism out there, I'd say this is the time to really bring it and show what is good, show what is possible. Give people something to celebrate. People like to celebrate, and they like to get behind a winning team, don't they? And so let's put our best foot forward on this. I know we will. I look forward to celebrating with you over the next couple of years. I look forward especially to the incredible work, and it's going to be a lot of work over the next year, but we are going to have a great, great time with it. And in the way, create new opportunity, new aspirations for this great state. Thank you. And now comes the special part of the program, which is to recognize individuals who've made such important contributions to this community and to this industry. So I'm going to now have the honor of handing out some awards. The first award, and I'm gonna have Kate, if you would come join us. Terrific, come on up, come around, do this. We have our photogs in place for the moment. Yes, all right, good. The first award is the Larry D. Meehan Lifetime Achievement Award. This is an award that is bestowed on one individual who has made a unique contribution to the growth and vitality of the Massachusetts tourism industry. As a member of the Greater Boston Convention and Visitors Bureau, Larry Meehan had a remarkable 30-year career in the tourism industry. I know that Larry meant a lot to so many of you. The person receiving this year's award is also beloved by this community, and she is the Senior Vice President of Sales of the Cape Cod Chamber of Commerce, Patty Lloyd. Come on up, Patty. We're celebrating Patty for celebrating 24 years of promoting Cape Cod, the islands, and Massachusetts.
People.
Congratulations, Patty. Next is the first ever Revolutionary Achievement Award. So this is a new award, but every year we will give this award and we will recognize an individual who has contributed to the Massachusetts tourism industry in a revolutionary way. We start off by recognizing someone for their innovative approach to the 250th anniversary of the American Revolution. As we've said, this is a big deal for our state. And the Revolutionary Achievement Award goes to the Executive Director of Revolution 250 Inc., Jonathan Lane. Congratulations, Jonathan. And now for the Film Industry Achievement Award. Everyone knows how important the film industry is in Massachusetts, and the LG and I are big believers in this industry. We thank you to the legislature for working to make sure that we had the tax credit in place. So, so important. We know having our state as a backdrop for so many films is just wonderful for us. It's great for business. It's great for our state. It's fun for all of us, isn't it, when you're at home and you can identify different places and locations. And importantly, it also has a huge impact on jobs and space. Also, we know it doesn't happen without a ton of hard work, especially a lot of work, unsexy work, behind the scenes, right? Making it all happen. And we wanted to take this moment to recognize this year's winner of the Film Industry Achievement Award to a location manager who has made outstanding contributions to the Massachusetts film industry over the last 40 years, and that is Charlie Harrington. Kate tells me that Charlie's work started with Witches of Eastwick and Ipswich. True story, huh? Wow. It's a good spot you found.
I think he worked on Hocus Pocus too.
Did you work on Hocus Pocus too? He's worked on everything. What hasn't he worked on? Yeah, 40 years. Awesome. Keep it up. It's great. Finally, the Award of Appreciation. This year, we are going to take a moment to present the Award of Appreciation, which is presented to one of Mott's own. So it's very special to us. And this year, it is presented to a person who is retiring after 19 years as Director of Research for his outstanding commitment and contributions to Mott, regional tourism councils, and the Commonwealth of Massachusetts in the tourism industry. We're pleased to be able to recognize our own Tony D'Agostino. Tony's retiring, but he's promising to be only a phone call away, so. Well, that concludes concludes the awards presentation of the program, and I'm going to turn the program back over to Kate. But again, thank you all for what you do. We're really pumped. We're really, really excited and looking forward to so many great things to come.